guys, my name is JessiMew, and welcome back to the Tribe of the Tides, where in the last episode we had our first reincarnation situation on this island. After Splash passed away in the ocean overnight, we had this little baby born into the pack, who of course we ended up naming Splash the Second. So the only real difference between him and Splash is that he has only one no paw. He managed to inherit one of the running legs, and of course he also looks a little bit more pale, and he has those gorgeous violet eyes. So I am very, very happy with him, and I'm hoping that what we can do in the future once he grows up is maybe breed him with Animiko over here. Because Animiko was the only girl born in the litter between Splash and Miko, which means that she does have the gills in her recessive trait, so it would be much more likely that they would have babies with the gills if they bred together. So assuming that we don't have like a safer baby, I guess, to use, assuming that Blossom and Kiriduke don't have a baby with maybe the claw instead of that no paw there, then we'll probably have Splash the Second breed with Animiko as soon as he grows up. But we will continue breeding Blossom and Kiriduke, and we also want to take a look at a couple of pairings over on this side of the island. So we have Twilight sitting here all alone, unfortunately, next to her berry bush, and I'm hoping that maybe Flame can make his way over there and breed with her so that we can hopefully start our official line of gatherers. Because right now our nimble fingers are kind of scattered all around the island. We don't have like a set path for our nimbled fingered creatures, and if we are going to move islands soon, then we really do need to figure out how we're going to gather up all of the food on the new island, because there is a chance that it could be very, very scarce. So Flame is going to make his way over here to breed with Twilight, probably in the next turn, actually. It looks like she might be growing up in the next turn, so we can get started on that right away. And of course, Sienna and Speck had their little family. Oh my goodness, I am so pleased with this family. Despite the fact that their children did end up inheriting the no-paw situation, they both have the cracker jaw. They both actually managed to inherit the cracker jaw, which means that even though they have no paws, they can still come over to this tree. The same tree that Sienna and Speck kind of made their journey over to and clear it out for the pack to use. They can come to this tree, they can knock down the acorns, and they can pick up all of the food with their cracker jaw. So I am so pleased with these little babies. I am so impressed that they managed to carry out the story of Sienna and Speck in such a fitting way. And I'm hoping that maybe we could have one of our perfect males from the other side of the island come over here and breed with Crystal. I'm thinking it'll probably be Ember, because he has a little bit more left of his life than Bamboo, so it's more likely that they can have a couple more healthy babies, I guess, before he passes away. So we'll have Ember start making his way over there as soon as possible, just so that he's in the area, which means that there is going to be a lot of action on the northern side of the tribe, at least for now. Though we can't forget about these guys over here, because this is the family where we might be seeing the birth of our very next queen. So I noticed when Syra was born that she is very, very close to becoming the next Animeme. The only thing she's really missing are those panda patterns that her mother has. So if we can possibly get a baby with the claw and the ram horns and of course the panda patterns too, then she would definitely be our little reincarnation of Animeme, and then maybe we could take that as a sign that we're ready to finally go off to the next island. Honestly, today we're just going to focus on refining all of our lines, making sure that our warriors are ready, our gatherers are ready, and of course our little guild creatures are ready too, so that we'll have enough opportunities to gather food on the next island and enough able bodies to defend ourselves from all of the predators on the island too. So to start things off, why don't we go ahead and actually have another baby with Blossom and Kiriduke, because we had a very good luck baby last time, so I have some high hopes. Luckily, since Splash the Second does have that running leg, he can do a little bit more on land while he's waiting to start his family. Actually, if we bring him right over here, he might be able to help, like, pick up some of these berry bushes. Maybe he could help Duke Tata actually pick from this one, since Duke Tata can only pick one berry at a time as it is. That might be quite helpful to make sure that we're gathering enough food per turn. But let's take a look at the mutation menu first, because of course we definitely want the gills in here. We want the gills to sit right in the 30% slot. And then the other thing we wanted was the claw, so that hopefully Blossom will be able to pass her claw along to her babies this time. Like, that would be the ideal situation if one of the guild creatures actually had the claw, because then they would actually be able to scoop up all of the fish that are swimming around in the ocean. But we'll have him breed with her, that way she can pick some of these berries over here. And of course Miko can just scoop up the rest with her nimble fingers, because she's one of the few creatures who actually has them. Then we want Flame to start making his way over here, so he'll scoot over here right next to Twilight, right next to her, so that he can also use this bush in the area too. And then we'll also have his brother start making his way, and we will cross our fingers that I won't end up having another twin betrayal anytime soon. Like, I think I'll be able to tell that Ember is different from Flame, because they do have the different eyes and the different manes. But just fingers crossed that I don't accidentally breed with the wrong one this time. Where can we actually place him, though, so that he's a little bit more helpful right now? Maybe right, like, we could place him by this berry bush, or we could have him maybe peek in the grass a little bit just to light up the area. I am still concerned with all of this darkness that we're leaving behind us, and that's Hunter 2, poor Hunter who passed away in the last episode, so he is just left in all of that darkness right now. I guess this family is just going to have to pick from their berries for now. I mean, the only problem with having so many different pairings kind of active at once is that we can really only breed one at a time because the mutation menu seems to take effect once you skip the day, so I don't want to accidentally mess it up for this pairing if we breed a different one instead. So for now, you guys can just come up here and pick your berries. I believe Kukirnu was picking from Strawberry's berry bush, so he can do that. And then we'll have his son, who actually inherited the poison fangs in his genetics. So that's quite interesting. If we want to bring that back, we would have to use Tanu. We'll go ahead and bring him maybe like right here to kind of explore the area a little bit more, because we did have a situation with a carnivore in this grass with Hunter. So it would be nice to clear that out a little bit, especially since we're thinking about moving islands pretty soon. And then of course, Sira, our little beast, can move like right here just to keep an eye on all of this darkness. And I think we're good now, so we'll just go ahead and have Bamboo pick all of these berries right here. We'll have Animiko pick up these two. It looks like we have like one more left on that bush, so somebody's going to have to come over there and help up or Animiko collect all of those berries. But other than that, I think it's just this family now, Sienna and Speck. So we should probably have Crystal move right here to knock down some more acorns. Oh my gosh, all of the acorns again. That is her first time knocking down the acorns too, I think. So that was pretty good. Not bad at all, little Crystal. We should probably also have Speck kind of like move his way over here just to spread out the darkness a little bit, just a little bit, and then Sienna can move right here too. And that should give them a little bit of a cushion just in case something spawns right in the strip right here, right on the shore actually. All of this shoreline is also darkness, so we'll have to be especially careful because these guys aren't exactly the strongest right now. So it's probably actually a good thing that the Fire Brothers are making their way over here, because that means that they'll at least be able to protect this family with their big claws. But other than that, I think we're about done. We could have Dooknu maybe sit like right here on top of the bunny burrow for now, just to keep an eye on it in case any little bunnies spawn, though we have so many creatures around here that I don't think a bunny would really be sneaking away. And I think that's it. So we'll go ahead and skip the turn and we'll see if maybe we can have extra special luck with this baby too, just like Splash the Second. Let's see. Nope. Not a good luck baby, but look at those eyes. Oh my gosh, where did you get the green eyes? That is adorable. Oh my goodness, she has the hemophilia unfortunately, but those green eyes, that is the first green-eyed creature we've had in this pack. And since her mother is carrying on the legacy of Flora with the different plant-related names, we'll go ahead and name her Ivy. There we go. So her name is Ivy and she is absolutely adorable and she has the claw too, which means that she'll also be able to protect us if we need it. So now it looks like Twilight has grown up, so we can get started on this family pretty soon. Flame has 11 days left of his life, so he actually has quite a bit to go. We want to make sure that the ones who are going to be passing away soon are breeding first, and I believe, yes, that is Kukirnu. He is probably the one who's going to pass away the soonest. We also have poor Bamboo here, who unfortunately was sick early on in his life, so he lost a bit of his lifespan anyway, and that's why I was a little bit concerned with breeding him with Animiko, because, I mean, he would just completely get destroyed by her spiky body. So yeah, let's go ahead with Kukirnu. We'll have him breed again with his mate Bloom, and we'll switch around the mutation menu just a little bit in the meantime, because of course, we probably will not be getting the gills on these creatures. I can't imagine that the mutation menu would work for this of all the creatures in the pack if we had so much trouble with Splash before. So instead, we'll place, of course, that claw in there and the ram horns, just like before, and we'll cross our fingers that maybe we'll end up with our new queen. Even if we don't, though, even if this pairing doesn't give us a new full animeme, I feel like Sira is a pretty safe bet regardless, because she is a little beast herself. So let's have Bloom move right to the nest. We'll have Kukirnu sit over here and breed with her. And then I guess we can move him straight back to a strawberry's bush just so that he's ready to pick from it in the next turn. And you could actually pick these berries for us. There we go. And we'll have Tanu continue exploring this way. He can peek in all of this grass to make sure that we're safe. We want to have Sira have her other gem too. and she may take on that special gem if we can't get a more suitable baby to animate anyway. So we'll have her for now come over here and help her brother peek in all of this grass, because of course she can't do any collecting, so she won't be going up to these berry bushes to collect the food. But now we can actually move little Splash the Second over to this bush so that he can help his, I guess this would be like his uncle maybe? That would be his uncle, but he can help his uncle collect the berries until he's ready to possibly breed with Animico. So we'll just keep them in the area just so that I don't forget that that's what we're doing basically. And then we'll have Miko pick up her berries as usual. And it looks like no new little bunnies over here, unfortunately. We could possibly move Kirduk a little bit farther away. I guess he could go right here just to keep the area lit up, since he's not going to be having a baby on this turn. And on the next turn, I think what we will do is start with the Flame and Twilight side of the family. That would probably be a good idea because we do definitely need our gatherers in the pack. Flame can go ahead and scoop up as many of the berries as he can. I think he actually picked that clean, and that's why we need the nimble fingers. That's why they are so helpful. We can start actually having Quartz move his way to the tree too, and we'll change his gem over to orange just like his sister and just like their father, because I thought that would be a good thing to keep in this family, especially since he inherited the spots. I'm so happy about that too. We can actually have Ronuduke move right here to pick up the berries and possibly any seashells. Oh my goodness, I almost missed that. There's a little shell over here that we can collect in the next turn, and even one right there too. As long as they don't get taken away by the waves, then we should be able to grab that up in the next turn. But we'll have Quartz move as far as he can, which seems to be like right here. So he still has a little ways to go before he can get to the other side of the tree. But Crystal, you can actually pick up a couple of the acorns already. And then I'm starting to get concerned about all of this darkness again. I mean, I guess Sienna and Speck. Oh my gosh, no, Sienna, you only have 3 days left. I didn't notice that. And Speck. Oh my gosh, that is going to be so sad when they pass away, our two little explorers. Well, they definitely have to stay with their family. I mean, we'll have Sienna sit like right here, we'll have Speck come over here and sit like right next to them so that they can all be right around this tree together, so that they can all keep each other company and hopefully pass away peacefully. But I suppose instead we could have Twilight move a little bit closer to this nest. In fact, she could probably clear out a little bit of this grass while she's waiting, and then Ember could do the same. You can peek in here, and then you can come down here and unpeek in all of this too. We have these full berry bushes back here. I mean, at least they're not getting eaten up by all of the bunnies. In fact, I think this might be our only bunny burrow in the entire island. I feel like it might be because we haven't really had any bunnies on this side of the island. At least we haven't noticed them, so it seems like we only have one bunny burrow despite all of these berry bushes. I mean, I can't really complain. We have a ton of berry bushes and we certainly have a ton of food, so we're not really hurting for more food sources at the moment. But let's see, we just have this family over here to deal with, and it looks like they don't really have many berry bushes to pick from anymore because Miko has picked them clean. So we might actually just go ahead and skip the turn. I think we're probably good. Let's go ahead and see what this little baby is going to look like. Maybe it'll be a nice good luck baby again. We'll go ahead and see. Let's see, is it going to have the panda patterns? Oh my gosh! It's a boy version of Animeme. Oh my gosh, I wasn't expecting that. Look at you, Duke Vaughn. You have the double claws, you have the ram horns, you have the panda patterns. Oh my gosh. That is so cool. So we could have like a king of the island too. What do you guys think I should name him though? If we do end up naming him like our queen Animeme, what kind of name should we give him? That is something that I am not quite sure of. So if you guys have a suggestion for that, then just leave it in the comments and maybe we'll do that in the next episode. We'll figure out what this guy's name is going to be because he definitely deserves a very fitting name for that appearance. I mean, I think, again, his fur color is just like the very original anime on our very first island, right? I'd have to go back and check, but yellow fur and red fur. And it looks like he has the normal eyes too, so that's good to see. He also passed the poison fangs again. And we were looking at that on Tanu, so that's something that we might want to keep an eye on too. If we do bring him to the next island, then maybe he could help us start that line of poison fanged creatures again. And it looks like he inherited at least one of the normal blood clotting slots, so that's also pretty good to see. But now I guess we should get started on the family between Twilight and Flame. So we'll have our mutation menu set up for them. We of course want our nimble fingers in the 30% slot. And then I think I also need the normal blood clotting in here too, because if I remember correctly, yeah, Twilight had the hemophilia, and Flame unfortunately does have the hemophilia in his genetics. So it is quite likely that they could end up with that. Luckily, they are definitely not going to end up with double no paws, there is a possibility that they could end up with a one no paw because of Twilight, but there's also a possibility that she could pass on her running leg instead. So we'll just see how it goes. We'll bring a flame over here to breed with her, then she can sit in the nest, and then you need to go way back over here because that is so much darkness. Oh my gosh, we have like this little rainbow of darkness around us right now, which is not very good. We'll have Quartz move over here, so that they are perfectly set up to collect all of their little acorns together. Crystal can grab these, and then on the next turn, it looks like Quartz is going to be able to grab a few more too. So we'll leave him there for now. And of course, Sienna and Speck, let's have you guys sit side by side together since this is actually Speck's very last turn. Oh, Speck, I am so sorry. I'm going to miss you so much. And so is Sienna, I think. We'll have Speck at least pick a couple of the berries for us so that he can do a little bit before his final turn. And then we want Ronuduk to come down here and pick up the shells too, like he was going to before. And it looks like they both stuck around for us, so that's good to see. He's not in the water, right? Yeah, he's not. I always get a little bit concerned about that, but we did learn that when they step on the paw prints, they're still technically above water, so it should be okay. We'll leave him right there and have Miko, of course, scoop up her berries too. She is also getting very close to the end of her life, and I mean, she was a very helpful member of the pack too, despite the fact that all of her babies ended up with a big nose, her big nose hidden away in her genetics. She did give us a chance to have all of these guild creatures. And speaking of which, we want to change Splash the Second's gem over to a blue too, so that he can have all blue gems just like his ancestor, Splash the First. And how much longer does he have before he grows up? About 3 days. I believe that's about 3 days worth of time before he's an adult. And Anamiko has 16 days left of her life, so I don't think we have too much to worry about there. But Bamboo, on the other hand, Bamboo, despite being one of our perfect males, he is definitely getting close to the end of his life too. I mean, maybe we could have them have just one baby, Anamiko and Bamboo. I mean, maybe we could, because it feels like such a waste to have one of our perfect males die without having one baby. Since this is kind of like an unplanned baby, I won't worry about the mutation menu too much for now. We'll just have Anamiko sit over here, we'll have Bamboo breed with her, and yes, unfortunately that's going to shorten his life even more. Oh, I am so sorry, Bamboo, but it's going to be worth it. It'll definitely be worth it because at least you can have one baby. And then you can sit next to your little berry bush again and pick the berries on the next turn. So we'll have, of course, Kukirnu pick from a strawberries berry bush just like before. And we'll have Bloom actually move out of the nest to not only light up the area, but to also allow our our kingly version of Anamiko to grow up too. And now just like before, her children can come over here and clear out the area for us. There we go. It looks like Tanu is fully grown too, so that's good to see. He can kind of like keep an eye on his sister, who is very, very daring herself, I think. She's kind of just like diving into this grass without a fear in the world. We do actually want Ember to possibly scoot a little bit closer now because I believe Crystal is growing up in the next turn, so they should also start their family. Like, we have so many families to focus on in this episode. Let's actually have Ember move closer to the nest underneath the tree because I think that's actually going to be the nest that they end up using. Now, since the bunnies haven't spawned just yet, we can have Dooknoo maybe move up here to light up the area for us. Maybe he should move right here, because again, I am concerned about leaving so much darkness around this tree in particular. But we'll have Kirduk instead take up bunny duty for now, just in case any little bunnies decide to come hopping out. And other than that, I think we might be done. And we just have a couple of berries over here to pick, of course. And Splash the Second, you might as well peek in this grass for us because that's about all that you can do right now. And then I think we're ready to skip the turn. So we have two babies to look at this time. We'll go ahead and watch Anamiko's first just to see what this one looks like. I wonder if it's going to have her spiky body though. That is the one concern. What? What? How did that happen? How on earth did that happen? Is it just because she had the gills in her recessives? Like, honestly, the gills seem to pass in a much easier fashion when they're in the recessive slot. Like, I don't know if that's true, but so far, this is crazy. So we have Ronuro at the moment, who has a claw, by the way, so he actually has the fishing skill too. Oh my gosh, and he has the normal blood clotting, which I believe is our first guild creature with actual normal blood clotting, so that's excellent to see. He has the normal eyesight. He does have one no paw, but the claw kind of makes up for it. So that's excellent. Let's go ahead and find a name for him too. Let's actually take a look at his model first though, because that might help us with a name. Oh my gosh, he has the green eyes too. Every single one of our guild creatures have had a different color eyes so far. They've all had the panda markings though, and this guy actually has the ram horns too, which is kind of neat. So since he's probably going to be working with Splash the Second so much, we'll go ahead and name him Splish. Splish and Splash. I thought that was very cute. That was a suggestion that a lot of you guys left for me after we named our original Splash. So that'll be fun. They can both go into the water at some point after maybe Splash II starts his family, because I do still want to see that happen. They can both dive into the water, and then Splash II can kind of like lure the fish over to a splish, and then he can snatch them up with his big claw. So hopefully in the next episode we can actually get started on that. And then of course we have this baby back here to take a look at. Did you hopefully inherit the nimble fingers? No, she didn't, but she did get the claw. Okay, so she got the claw from her father, and she actually managed to keep the running leg from her mother, it looks like. That's good, and look at that, perfect genetics too. Normal blood clotting, normal eyes. Oh my gosh, that is perfect. Okay, and the spit snout too, like, look at those eyes. The yellow eyes with the spit snout, they're almost like glowing. That is crazy. Okay, so let's give her a name too, because her name is also Anamiko, which is not exactly going to fly. So since her mother's name is Twilight, we'll go ahead and name her Dawn, to kind of go in line with those eyes, those big yellow eyes, and of course to go in line with her father as well, because her father's name is Flame, so it's kind of like a cross between both of their name themes. But I think we might actually want to breed them again. I think that might actually be a good idea, and I just noticed that poor Twilight doesn't have her special gem either, so we'll change that over. And it looks like Crystal also needs her gem to change too. There we go. Yeah, so we might breed them again, but then again, how much time do we have left on poor Ember? Oh my goodness, 5 days. Okay, and Speck. Oh my gosh, Speck also passed away right on top of this acorn too. Oh my goodness, so actually Quartz could like collect the acorn that his father left for him. And then Sienna, of course, is going to end up passing away on this turn too. So this is officially the end of our little exploring duo, but I am so glad that they managed to at least start a family, a very helpful family for the pack. We should probably actually have them breed on this turn, just so that Sienna can know she can rest easy, that her family is going to continue. So we'll bring Crystal over to this side and sit her right in the nest. And then we'll work on the mutation menu. So we definitely want the cracker jaw in there, of course. We need them to continue that line of the cracker jaw. And then I think the normal eyes will go in the 10% slot, because of course Ember is our perfect male, so he has the normal eyes himself, but Crystal is one of the only creatures with the short-sighted eyes. So I'm hoping that that will be able to override it. But we'll have them breed. We'll go ahead and have him breed with her so that she can at least collect a couple of these acorns. And then a Quartz can do the same. And I think, actually, Sienna could spend her last turn knocking down some more for her children. Look at that. That was pretty good. So they'll have even more to collect on the next turn. And we can have Ember just scoop up these berries for now. Let's see, do you have any more shells to collect? Let's have you scoot along the shoreline here. There we go, a nice little bounty of shells. All right, so that gives us a couple more points to use too. And then we'll have you scoop up some more berries for us. He still has 9 days left, so yeah, it would probably be a good idea to breed him a little bit later. Though how about you? How about you back here? 4 days left for you. I think I want them to have just one more baby, just in case we can have like a female version just like Animeme, because I am still pretty hopeful that we can have our reincarnation of Animeme take us to the next island. But it looks like from here on out, it's just food collecting, right? We just have all of these berries to pick, so we'll go ahead and do that. You guys can continue carving your tracks through all of this grass at least. I would like to explore the entire island so that we can maybe cut down some berry bushes before we leave. That might help us at least give us a little bit of a boost in food right before we're ready to ship off to the next island. And Duktata, you can pick these. I think, yeah, Splash has 2 more days left until he's ready to grow up, so pretty soon he'll be able to start his family too. And then we can have a couple more guild creatures ready to dive into the water, and we'll be able to pick which ones would be best to bring with us to the next island as well. For now, why don't you actually come over here and peek in some of this grass for us? There we go, and then we'll have you guys start moving this way. We definitely want you to allow your child to grow at least, and we'll clear out some of this darkness with your good eyes, because she does have the normal eyes as well. And for that matter, your baby can kind of like stick with you, help you out, just like banish all of this darkness in the area. And I think that might be just about it. We could have Duknu come over here and peek in this grass right here. And maybe for that matter, he could at least pick up some of these berries, because it is such a waste having all of these full berry bushes back here with nobody to pick from them. So we'll have him do that. We'll leave Kirduk right on top of this bunny burrow, and we'll go ahead and skip the turn and cross our fingers that we end up having a very, very nice baby from this pairing too. Hopefully one with a cracker jaw. We'll see if we can maybe get it to pass over the normal nose that the father has. and Sienna will hopefully be able to see her first grandchild too as she passes away. So let's see. Oh my gosh. Oh, that is so sad. But at least she knows that she actually has a grandchild in the pack now. And look at that. He looks almost just like his father. Oh, that is adorable. He does have the cracker jaw in his genetics. So again, we could pull that out again. Now, since he looks so much like his father, we'll go ahead and stick with his naming theme, I think. And let's name him Bolt. We'll name him Bolt, kind of like a lightning bolt, especially with those eyes. And then I believe the next thing we wanted to do was just have one more baby way back here. We'll have one more baby with Kukirnu and his mate Bloom. So we'll move their little baby out of the nest. Duke Von right now. His name is currently Duke Von, but we might change that later. We'll sit him right there. We'll have her sit in the nest, and then we'll swap around the mutations one more time. So we'll have, of course, those big claws. Where are they? There they are. These things get so mixed up after a while. I feel like I need to come back in here and organize them all again. But we'll have the claw in the 30% slot. We'll have the ram horns wherever they are too. There they are. We'll have the ram horns in the 10% slot, and then we'll have them breed one last time to see if maybe we could have our little goddess Animeme bring us to the next island. And then look at this baby. Oh my goodness, you are adorable. Let's change your gem over to blue as well, since all of our guild creatures have had blue so far. You can actually move up here so that you'll be ready to explore the world with Splash the second pretty soon. We'll have him peek in this grass, and then he can start moving back over here to Animico. And Bamboo, oh my gosh, I thought it might be your last day too. Oh, that is so sad. Bamboo was one of my favorites just because I love his color combinations. The panda patterns, the beautiful fiery mane, and those blue eyes. That is definitely a gorgeous combination, and I hope we see somebody like him again in the future. And then we just have a couple berries over here. Oh, Miko, you're going to pass away too. Oh, all of these older generations of creatures are just dropping like flies right now, and it is so sad. And then our sibling explorers can also carve their paths this way as well. It looks like Sierra has fully grown too, so that's good to see. She should be a little bit safer back here just in case they do run into a carnivore. Though honestly, it looks like they have just about cleared out all of this grass anyway, so we should be just fine. We have almost completely conquered this entire island. There are just a few straggling pieces of grass left, so we have got to be almost ready to just jump over to the next island pretty soon. I don't want to jinx it, but I feel like we can definitely make it on the second island. So let's have Crystal actually move back to her previous position over here. She can scoot right back to where she was before, right where her mother died too. Oh my gosh. And then we'll have Quartz go ahead and pick up a couple of acorns himself. There we go. So they are definitely helping us out, and that is so cool. We can have Ronudu come down here and pick up his shells. He is our only shell collector at the moment, but he is doing a very good job at it. And then he can scoot along the shore, and there's some more fish. I think they spawn from the seaweed, right? I think this is where they're spawning from. They always seem to hang around this area anyway, so I'm going to assume that's the case. So let's go ahead and spread these guys out so that they'll be ready to have a baby on hopefully the next turn. We could actually leave Twilight right there if we wanted to. I guess she could go ahead and just peek in some of this grass though, just so that it's cleared out, and just so that we have a little bit less darkness in the area. And Flame, of course, can pick his couple of berries, and I think that might be it. I think that's just about all of the turns that we need to make anyway. So here's the final baby of Bloom and Kukirnu. We'll zoom in on them and watch as hopefully another good luck baby is born. Oh my gosh, oh, that is so cute. Was I not just asking for a baby with the panda patterns and the blue eyes and the fiery mane? Oh my gosh, and he managed to inherit the ram horns too. So in a way, it's almost like Bamboo was kind of reincarnated in the form of his sister's baby, so that is adorable. We'll have to figure out a good name for him too, kind of like to honor that. Maybe Thorn? That would go in line with the plant theme that we're giving their children, and since he has that giant claw, that might be quite fitting for him in particular. So Thorn. We have Thorn, we have Duke Von currently, unless we find a better name for him, and then we of course have Tanu and Sierra way over here making their path through the grass. So that should be the end of this family for now, and instead we'll go over here and focus on our nimble-fingered creatures again, because we really, really need to get that to pass in their genetics in one way or another. So let's switch around the mutations one more time. We'll put the nimble fingers in the 30% slot, and then I believe we wanted to have, was it the normal blood clotting in the 10% slot? I believe it was. So we'll have her come over here, he can breed with her, and then she can sit straight in this nest. And then look at that, Splash the second, you are fully grown now. Oh my goodness, so we can actually have you come over here where Bamboo used to sit. Oh, that's a little bit sad. And then he can hopefully start his family with Animico on the next episode. So Animico, you can pick your berries for now. You are going to be very, very busy on the next episode. Again, I am a little bit upset that she's going to end up shortening Splash the Second's life just because of that spiky body. That is definitely not going to help us if we continue to carry that in the future. Splish also has it in his recessive, so we're going to have to watch out for that if we do decide to breed him too. But let's just collect all of our berries for now. We'll scoop up strawberries, berries of course, and then we'll have Bloom sit over here next to her baby. And Duke Vaughn, you can just kind of like stay there to light up the way, I guess. We'll give you your orange gem too. And then of course our exploring siblings can go ahead and peek in a little bit more of this grass. I think they are going to officially clear all of the grass that is left on this island. They could even come up here and finish these last two pieces if they wanted to. I mean, I think we have probably found all of the berry bushes that we're going to on this island. I really doubt there's going to be any more resources in these couple of patches of grass, but we might as well just explore it anyway, just to be sure. And we definitely need somebody else up here. Like, we definitely need somebody to come over here and hopefully scoop up the rest of those berries. In fact, let's have Flame come right here so that on the next turn he can do just that. And we'll go ahead and see what their next baby is going to look like. The very final baby of this episode. Cross your fingers that it finally has those nimble fingers. Let's see. What? What on earth? Why on earth do the gills come out when I am least expecting them? What is going on here? So once again, no nimble fingers, which is a little bit disappointing, but she honestly is not that bad. The normal eyes, the claws, so again, she can actually scoop up the fish in the water, and she has the normal blood clotting too. What on earth, guys? Seriously, what on earth? I mean, Twilight did have the gills again in her recessives. Like, is it honestly easier to pass when it's just sitting in the recessives? I wonder if that's the case, but that gives us another baby that we can possibly have more gilled creatures with, and another baby to hopefully refine that line of gilled creatures too. Because I think it would be particularly helpful if we could have the fishing tail on these guys, because that would give them a little bit of a boost in fishing, and then hopefully we'll be able to catch more fish when we do eventually move islands. But that is just crazy! That is absolute craziness! Let's go ahead and actually take a look at her model too, if we can find it in here. Oh my gosh, she's beautiful though, isn't she? I really like that color of her fur along with the gills, and of course the color of her ram horns too. She has gray ram horns. Oh, that is so cool. It would be really nice too to possibly try to get the water body on them so that they'll be like honest water breathing creatures. They'll have all of the water traits, the webbed paws, that might be a good one to have too, so that they can swim even farther, and then they can get over to those fish and scoop them up straight away. So not exactly what we were intending to have happen with this side of the family, but honestly, I am fine with that. I can definitely live with some more gills. We do definitely need to have more nimble fingered creatures in the pack before we move islands though, because at this point we're not going to have enough able bodies to help us collect all of the food that we need to survive on the next island. So once we do finally get at least one baby with those nimble fingers, then I think we will be ready to finally move over to the normal island. We have 9 ports to use again, so we'll pick which creatures we want to take with us, hopefully the ones with the best immunity genes, the best genetics, the perfect creatures too. Those are really important. The ones who are without the hemophilia, who are without the short-sighted eyes, those are definitely going to be very valuable because we'll have to deal with, again, those wandering males on the harder islands. As well as those big bluebirds. There are leeches on the harder islands. There are crabbits too, which I am quite excited to share with you guys. But we'll focus on all of that in the next episode. So for now, thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you all next time. Bye, guys!